picture this, if you will. 200 18 to 20-year-old men in a circle, naked, facing outward, bent over. Everybody's looking through their legs at everybody else's butt. There's a doctor walking around, spreading butt cheeks, peeking in everybody's butthole. He's got a little flashlight, and he's really getting tight in there, and he's spreading that last little bit of cheek to see that hole, and it's like he's inspecting, like he would look in your ear or something. And what do you think he's looking for in there? I didn't go to Vietnam. Got an education. Didn't want one, but I got one. Work for the SDS or the FBI. LSD came from the CIA. When I dropped out of school, I got another education. When they gave me a 1A and inducted me. Timothy Leary lives in Bel Air. Tune in. In 1968, I joined the SDS. They gave me a petition, and I sat in front of the Naval ROTC building collecting the names and addresses of all the nabobs of negativism in my area. The next day, two FBI agents came to my dorm and threatened me with a jail term. Then they went down the list I had provided them and threatened everyone with prison. The CIA still uses this method in Central America, but they don't threaten the people with prison. They just fucking kill them.
This was to be a gala occasion for a little Negro college from Mississippi appearing in Carnegie Hall with the great Duke Ellington. Martin Luther King, 20 minutes ago, died.
Sweetheart,
protest was over. Now was try to be a Quaker or a Christian Scientist or queer or something. A mental thing. I had other ideas, like maybe taking LSD in the bottom of Grand Canyon.
Anger!
I'm gonna go to Vietnam because I'm never gonna die. You get plenty of lives if you do die anyway. Just come back and have another one. You know, you can just come back and next week it'll be a different flavor. You know, you come back and you get a different flavor every week for a special. United States Police Force coming. Look out.
Just ask the answers.
About the helicopter ride, where he's laying in the back of it, and all the dead guys, and he's the only one alive, and the medic tourniquets his leg, and then the medic dies, and then the guys, the Viet Cong guys come around, and they don't kill him, they leave him, he lays there in his blood for 3 days, you think he's safe, you want to go to...
Sergeant Causey. Pigs ate the little boy, and then Gil took his machine gun.
New World Order.
I spent 8 years in the penitentiary.
New World Order.
And then he lied. His leg got blown off, his leg back on.
New World Order.
But they couldn't sell his brain back. Da-na-na-na. So he carries a 357 Magnum to work
every day.
nah, you think he's safe? He was crucified on the ground with bamboo stakes. They came and got him just before they were gonna take his weenie off. His weenie is never gonna be safe again. Tie a yellow ribbon round my testicles. He stepped on a mine. He was a good friend of mine. He's a good friend of mine. Stepped on a mine. Oh. They wouldn't take me. They wouldn't take me. No, they wouldn't take me. I had a note from a shrink.
Anger.
The Vietnam War with Walter Cronkite will continue in a moment.
I might say here that in the 1st Division, we have a very ironclad policy of positively identifying our kills. We claim probables when we aren't completely sure, but have a high percentage of assurance. Whenever we claim body count, we have either actually picked up the body or we've had two men see the body on the battlefield before we left the battlefield area. So we do not, contrary to what may have been put out someplace in the press, we do not exaggerate.
They displayed deadly hand-to-hand combat skills. They gave the general an extremely graphic display, killing rabbits, rats, and chickens, then eating them raw.
That is a typical standard function or capability which any special forces conduct in the
United States.
New World Order.
They wouldn't take me. They asked me what I'd do, and I said, you give me a gun, I'll come back and blow your fucking head off.